it going, everyone? Leo with the Irish Zombie Nation. Today, we are going to be taking a look at what is now my favorite backpacking and camping chair. It is what I am sitting in right now, and it is by far the most comfortable camping chair that I've come across yet. A while back, I did a video talking about, you know, my process of choosing different camping chairs, different options available. None of them ever worked out perfect for me. This one does. This is the Duralounge. Excellent, lightweight backpacking chair. I mean, it's not as lightweight as some, but for what you're getting, it is still lightweight and very comfortable, and that is most important. So what I'm gonna do right now, I am going to tear this sucker down. I'm gonna put it back in its carrying bag. I'm gonna show you what it looks like there, and then I'm gonna break it out, show you how it's put together, how easy it is, how simple it is. And we're gonna go over pretty much the pros on this sucker, because there really isn't any cons. None that I'm aware of anyway, or that I found. So thanks for joining me. Here we go. All right, Nation, so here it is. This is the Duralounge in its carrying case. You can see it is not too bad as far as size goes. You could strap this to the outside of your backpack. That's what I do. The carrying handles right here make it very easy. I have a couple gear hangs on the outside of my bag. Put a little carabiners, hold it right above my sleeping pad. There's also some webbing back here if you want to do some kind of molly stuff to it, or a little tab right here to hang it with a carabiner. However you want to do it, you can do it. Now, surprisingly, for as large as this chair is, this is a pretty small size of a stuff sack, and it is very lightweight. This whole contraption weighs 2.2 pounds. So, I mean, that's double the weight of the smaller Helionox, but you're also not squatted down like you're taking a crap in the woods while you're sitting there trying to have your coffee. This thing is definitely like a lounge chair. Very, very comfortable, especially for bigger guys like myself. So, as far as getting it out of here, let's see. We're just going to unzip it like this. Open like so, and pull it out of the carrying case. Now that we have the chair, just simply unroll it. You can see this is a nice, very thick headrest you have up here. I'd say that's probably an inch thick of probably closed cell foam in there. Open it up like this. Here is the pegs, or not pegs, the aluminum frame right here. I should probably get a better shot of this. So let me move the camera over and I'll show you putting this thing together. It kind of does it itself in some ways. So here's the frame. As you can see, it just wads up like that. Everything is shot corded together. This frame is made out of a 7075 air grade aluminum alloy, very strong. It can hold up to 300 pounds. So me being 230, I am just fine. You pretty much just kind of open it up. You see, and it kind of starts to put itself together. What doesn't fit in, you just slide into the holes like this. Very, very simple construction, simple design. This is like a lot of the other backpacking chairs you find out there, except this has a higher back to it and it's more comfortable. So you can see there's some nice rounded feet on the bottom. That's very good. Like this ground right here is some type of like mulch or something, very easy to sink into, but those feet do not allow that. So now that we have the frame together, we grab the seat and just slide it on. All right, the seat itself is made out of a 600 denier Oxford polyester, very durable, very thick, and very comfortable. Does have some mesh in certain areas. There are some spots right here to slide the upper back of the frame into, and then some little connectors down here. If you've seen these type of backpacking chairs before, nothing new here. So pretty much you just simply start with the back first, because those are the longer poles. Get them all straight. You just come over here and slip it right into the little section here. Holds the back in place. I only do it about halfway, because if not, it makes it harder to get this side in. The other side, over here, bend that over. The first couple times you put this together, it's harder to do, but once you get it broken in, it's very easy. You just slide those down like this. Then you do the bottom. Little connections right here, right like that. This is the harder one. And there you go. No time at all. That took about 30 seconds to put together. And now you're ready to sit back and relax. It does have some mesh pockets on the side right here, so you could slip, you know, whatever, your pen, your phone, snacks, or whatever you're using at the time. There's pockets on both sides. A little bit of mesh right here for breathability. Very, very comfortable chair. So now I'm going to show you how easy it is to sit in. All right, I had to get it on some stable ground. Now that I've got it nice and stable, I can just sit down. If you're wearing a large knife, that's not a problem with a chair like this. What I do is I just hold it close to my body so it doesn't get on the outside of the chair when I sit down. Hold that, and there we go. Very comfortable. It's got a nice headrest right here. You can lean back, relax, enjoy a cup of coffee, read a book, whatever you want to do. I cannot tell you how comfortable this chair is. What's really nice is how straight I am sitting. When I'm sitting in this thing, my legs are almost perfectly straight out from my body. A lot of those other camping chairs, the smaller Helionox and such, you know, you're all squinched up like this because it's real low to the ground. I think the clearance on this one, you've got about 15 inches from your butt to the ground. And for me, 6'1", I mean, that's perfect. I have no problems sitting in this chair very, very comfortably. I've taken it out on many trips and I absolutely love it. Now, breaking it down, just as easy as putting it up. All you do, come over here, start at the bottom, just do everything in reverse. Take the seat off, take the back off. Now you do have to kind of slide these out at the same time. Otherwise, the little black tip on the edge right here will pop off. And everything being held with shock cord, yep, I can already tell it did right there. All right, yep, there we go. Just got to get it out of there. There we go. Slide that out, and you're done. Just leave that off to the side for a second. Wind's killing me over here. All right, and then to break this down, just tear it down. Just like this, take all the sections apart. And they all will lean towards the center bar here, like this, that, that, bam, 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 bam. There's nothing specific you need to do with this. You just take it apart, bunch them all together like this. Then to put it away, grab your seat right here, the bottom part where your butt goes, put that right there, slide this up, fold in the little pockets on the side, get the leaves out of there, and then you just roll it up. Just like that, and then put it back in the stuff sack. It's that easy to break down and that easy to set up. I set it up again because I'm gonna be sitting in it for the rest of this trip, so I need to have it set up. But I also wanted to show you a few items. The rubber feet I was talking about, there you go, nice round discs. Prevent you from sinking into the ground on soft ground like I have over here. I've sat in mud before with other chairs, and if they don't have these type of discs on there, you go right into the ground. The height on it, like I said, is very comfortable. As far as being a bigger guy, I like the mesh pockets. The durability on this thing seems to be really good. This is my fifth trip, something like that I've taken out on, and it is excellent. Now the weight, 2.2 pounds. Some people are gonna say that's too heavy for backpacking. Well, that kind of depends on what type of backpacker you are. Me, I only hike a few miles in. You know, I'll do 2-3 miles in, find a campsite, and that's where I hang out. So doing a couple miles with this on my back, not a big deal. I do not want to hike 20 miles in a day in general at all, but I also don't want to do it with another 2-pound chair on my back. Better than to find a stump or something to sit on. But I'm older, I got a bad back, I got bad knees. When I'm at camp, I like to have a nice comfortable place to sit, and the Duralounge chair is awesome for it. I keep wanting to say Duralounger. I don't know, I just love this chair a lot. So I definitely recommend it. All right, everyone, so there you go. That's a look at the Duralounge, my new favorite backpacking and camping chair. It is the most comfortable chair I have come across. I can't say enough good things about it. No one sent me this chair to review. I paid for it out of my own pocket through Amazon. You can pick them up for 44 bucks. They come in two different colors. They're all black, of course, but the frame and the stitching around the edge here is either in red or blue, whatever you want. I went for red, but you know, blue's your thing, get the blue. I will put a link in the description box below where you can pick one of these up on Amazon, and if you use that link, it helps support me. It's my influencer store or whatever through Amazon. So if you purchase it through there, it costs you nothing extra, but it helps me out so I can buy more items like this to review. I'd appreciate it if you would use that link. So thanks for joining me. If you got any questions, you know what to do. Comments down below, like, share, and subscribe. I'm gonna get back to my coffee. I'm gonna kick back and lounge in this Duralounge. Thanks for joining me. Until next time, see you around the fire.